Sometimes those accounts will not be removed. So I always tell people just send a letter because you could have got better results by just sending a letter to that company. So if you want to dispute an account, let me make sure I can do it on my end before I tell y'all I can do something and I can't show you. Oh, yeah, it's working over here. Okay, it's making sure. Okay, so let me show you what that will look like. So disputing an account through Credit Karma, how to dispute an account through Credit Karma. Then I'll show you what you should do if you want to fill out an actual letter. So don't forget to, everybody should have Credit Karma. It's free. Everybody should have Credit Karma. So make sure you guys get Credit Karma if you don't have them already. Let me share my second screen with you all. Okay, perfect. So these are the negative accounts on someone's credit report, right? So if you can see, this is TransUnion. You can only dispute TransUnion through Credit Karma. That's why I always tell you guys to send a letter. It's 55 cents to send a letter. But this is Credit Karma. So if you want to dispute an account through Credit Karma, all you got to do is click on the account, go down and click dispute an error. So dispute an error. And then too, you will see they're asking you, why would you want to dispute an account? But that's how you would actually dispute the account through Credit Karma. You could pick whatever you want to pick in regards to what's going on with your account. Do you not know about this collection? Do you not know about the knowledge of this account at all? Is this a fraudulent account? You know, these are different options you can use. And then too, you'll be able to click two of these and then leave any comments that you want to leave. Now, I always tell people, yeah, you can do dispute through Credit Karma, but a lot of times those accounts, they won't be removed. It's just easier if you send a letter to the credit bureaus. So these are all the accounts that's on TransUnion. And let me see. These are the two accounts that's on Equifax. So if you guys, and then I believe too, these accounts are duplicates. So this is the actual letter that we did, and don't be alarmed. I always get a lot of people, stop showing show socials. I literally showed them, this was a blank letter. I showed them how to fill out this letter. At first it was a blank letter, but we put a fake name, the address, social security number, the date of birth, the name of the credit bureau, which is Experian. And then we just copy and paste the name of the account and the account number. So you can see right here, these two accounts, this account is right here, NCB is right here, and then Midland is right here. Now, don't forget, you guys don't have a copy of your credit reports on Credit Karma. I was trying to show people what to do if you can only use Credit Karma. Yeah, I tell you guys to get your credit reports for a dollar with IdentityIQ, and after that, they're going to charge you $21.99. But if you guys don't have that option because you can't afford to do it or whatever the case may be, then you can use Credit Karma, but all you want to do is any account that you see on TransUnion and Equifax, you want to automatically add it to Experian. So these are accounts that's actually on TransUnion. I added them here, but since it was a duplicate for Equifax, we didn't touch it at all. But this is the actual Experian letter. We blocked out like the good juicy information to help get the account removed. We blocked that off here, and you can see we'll go down. This is the letter to Equifax, which has these two accounts right there. Can you see that? And we didn't have the account number. Usually I'll tell you guys to put the account number on here, but we didn't have the account number. So all we did was just put the balance on here. But this is how you would write a dispute letter, and then you'll just mail it into the credit bureaus. For those people that's a part of the exclusive membership, you guys already have a copy of my dispute letter. So all you have to do is just plug in the name of the account and then to the balance. Or if you have the account number because you have IdentityIQ, then use that. And two, you're going to have more lingo on here. Like you'll see like my copyright information down at the bottom. You just delete all those extra things. But if you have any questions, I have a lot of videos showing you how to fill out these letters. But this is, to me, the best way to get accounts removed from your credit reports by actually sending a letter in to the credit bureaus. Now, sometimes this is where I find hiccups with people when it comes down to getting accounts removed from your credit reports. Sometimes if you have a new address, let's say if you just moved to this address, right? It's an address I made up. If you just moved to this address, the credit bureaus probably don't know your address. So you need to make sure that this address is added to your credit report. For those people, that's kind of tricky. Like I used to tell people, you know, use your cousin address. Use your cousin address. Get rid of all your old addresses, any address where you did any dirt at. Get all those addresses removed from your credit report.